Welcome to my another video lecture, design of induction motor for electric water pump in automotive industries. And I am Dr. Lennon, associate professor in School of Electrical Engineering, Vellore Institute of Technology, Chennai campus. So my sincere thanks to my management, Infoltica Corporation and Mentor Graphics to provide this software and for their support. So first of all, in any vehicles, especially automotive vehicles like car, bus, van, people may see mechanical belt driven pump. This mechanical belt driven pump always runs at the speed as equal to the engine speed. So the important improvement for this vehicles comes from the to replace this mechanical pump into water pump, electric water pump, which makes the entire vehicle more economical and it leads to maximum fuel savings. So these are the few electric water pumps at present people are using with different voltage levels, 12 volt as well as 24 volt. So let us see the specifications of this electric water pump. So as far as Davis Craig is concerned, they are having different electric water pumps rated from flow rate with a different liters per minute, as well as pump material, different voltage levels and different operating temperatures also. So these are the different types of electric water pumps usage in automotive industries at present. So if you see the product selection guide of this electric water pump and controllers, let us check with here electric water pump. So it is useful for engines up to 2 liters and 3.5 liters electric water pump, 115 is going to useful. Similarly, for different engines, including drag racing, drifting and speedway, off-road vehicles, so different electric water pumps are available in the market with a different combo of voltages, 12 volt or 24 volt, with a different controller switch. And you can find this product selection guide and different electric water pump series from the sources given in this slide. So today we are going to design an electric water pump which is based on induction motor drive. So the specifications we are going to deal in this lecture is going to be input voltage is 24 volts DC, rated speed is 4600 RPM, rated power is 380 watts, maximum stator outer diameter is 127 mm and maximum axial length of the core is 72 mm. We require a PWM control because the speed is going to vary from 4600 to 5000 RPM. So we choose induction motor drive for this application. Previously people are using commutator motors or otherwise BLDC. And the temperature limit of the motor is in the range of minus 40 degrees Celsius to 125 degrees Celsius. So first of all, why we choose the induction motor for this electric water pump application. So one of the most important reason is it's a well established technology, robust construction, so there will be no permanent magnet materials or otherwise coils on the rotor. Either it is going to be a copper bar or otherwise aluminium bar which is going to withstand the temperature more than 200 degrees Celsius, and avoidance of high cost permanent magnet materials. Capital investment in manufacturing technology is much lower than permanent magnet material. Most importantly, approximately 20% lower cost than brushless DC machine. Here PWM control is required and simpler VVEF control is more than sufficient for this type of application. And compared with vibration, noise or torque ripple, it is also better than existing commutator motor. So we prefer an induction motor for this application. Let us start with the basic specifications, and the entire lecture is the entire design is based on motor solve from Infoltica Corporation, and now it is towards Mental Graphics, acquired by Mental Graphics. So if you see, if you open the page of induction motor, actually there are four different types of motors available in Motosolve: induction, brushless DC, commutator DC, and switcher reluctance machine. So if you open the page and choose the induction motor drive, so the first page is going to be the prototype design page, is going to be resembled like this. So in this, you just click design, prototype design. In that, you just drop down design, and in that choose prototype design. And in that prototype design, we need to fill this specifications required by our application. So the first thing is supply type. So it is a voltage driven, either it is maybe a voltage driven or current driven. I choose voltage, it's a voltage driven drive. So I choose voltage driven. Supply voltage is 24 volt DC. Synchronous speed is 4900, so that the required rated speed, it is possible to come around for 4600, and rated slip is 5%. Outer diameter, as already in the specifications given, it is 127 of the stator. Air gap, we choose 0.6 mm. Stack height, the maximum is 72. And rotor location is inside. And rotor type is a round bar with aluminium. And number of bars is 30. Here it is 30 bars. Stator type is round stator type. And number of phases is 3. Number of poles, it's a 4-pole machine. Number of slots is 36. Number of slots, so one, this is 36 slots. So number of slots per pole is 36 divided by 4. It is going to be 9. So one can add friction, windage, stator roll losses if you want to get the accurate efficiency, or otherwise you can leave as it is. This is all about prototype design one, which is going to be the input specification of the machine. So coming to the next one, if you click the general settings, it is also going to be similar with the prototype design. Whatever the values you feed in the prototype design page, the same thing is going to be replicated in general settings. So I just skip that one, and the next one is rotor. If you just click the rotor, then it is going to be displayed like this. So this is going to be skew angle, that is the angle of the rotor. So for the initial condition, we didn't give any skew angle, but the final for the final model, we give a skew angle of 5 degrees. So the diameter, inner diameter, that is here, it is going to be 16 mm, and the outer diameter is 73.2 mm. Slot depth, this is the slot depth, it is 14.9. Tang angle 22.5. Slot opening width, this one, the slot opening width is 0.9. To tip thickness is also 0.929. So the tooth width is this one, the tooth width is 3.16. So these are the things we need to give in the rotor page. So coming to the next one, rotor end ring. So if you take the automatic, click the automatic, automatically it is going to calculate the inductance and resistance, inner diameter, outer diameter, thickness, bar dimension, everything based on the rotor end ring. So no need to give anything apart from this one. Automatically it is going to calculate the end ring values, everything. So the next one is stator. So in stator, you need to give slot depth. This is slot depth, it is 12 mm. Slot opening width, this is slot opening width, 0.5 mm. To tan angle, it is 12.5 degrees. Then to tip thickness, this thickness is going to be 1.5. tang radius, this is tang radius, 0.25. top fillet radius is also 0.25. most important in specification is stator winding. Coming to the stator winding, so the connection type we are using here is for analysis, it is delta. Number of parallel paths is 1. Diode voltage drop, as this is the PWM drive, so it is 0.6. Switch voltage drop is 0.2 volts. Switch frequency is 6000 hertz. Coil placement, it is side by side. Number of layers is 2, so it's a side by side coil. Slot liner thickness, this is for insulation purpose. Coil separator thickness, this is coil separator thickness. And slot wedge thickness, this is slot wedge thickness. Wire size method, we choose AWG 16, so that the corresponding conductor area is going to come here. So AWG number 16 and the corresponding conductor area is this one. Number of strands is 2. Winding type is lab, that is distributed winding. Number of coils per set, coils per set is 1. Coil span is 6. 6 means you see here A1, it goes to here. So that is 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that is the coil span. Number of layers is 2. 2 layer, 1, 2. Side by side, it is side by side. So number of turns is going to be 6. 6 turns in one coil. And based on that, it is going to calculate what is the slot fill factor. Slot fill factor is approximately 51%, and bare slot is 47%. And winding phase resistance is 0.1595. Line to line resistance is 0.1063. Winding factor is 83.1%. Angular speed is called 100 degree. End winding resistance is 0.08364. End winding inductance equals 21.83 microhenry, and broad slot area, so bare slot area without the coil is 33.18 mm², and this conductor area is going to be 1.309 mm². Bare slot fill factor is 47%, and coil fill factor is 51%. So at most level we can use the 50%. If it is 50 to 55%, we can utilize 100% of the coil. So 52%, approximately 52% of the coil fill factor we get here. So the design is going to be somewhat optimal as far as winding layout is concerned. Next, go to the stator winding chart, click the stator wind, drop down the stator winding, go to the stator winding chart. In that, we have a chart to display method. Different display methods are available. First, you choose winding factor and phase. As far as this application is concerned, we have 3 phases. I choose A phase, and you just click a result. Once if you click winding factor, then automatically it is going to give the winding factor with respect to the harmonic index. So the basic idea to know this winding factor is, if the winding factor is 0 in 3rd, 9 and 15 harmonic, then the efficiency of the machine bit is going to be better than when compared with if there is any harmonic index in 3rd order, 9th, 15th, like that. So the next one is the same thing, stator winding chart. Drop down the chart to display. In that, go to gauges diagram, which is going to give the connections of phase A coil and phase B coil. And almost ideal case, if it is going to be straight, then there will be no harmonics and all. The set of the winding is wound in the exact manner. Whereas if you see here, phase A coil, it is going to be here. And phase B coil, phase A coil 2 is like this, coil C is like this, coil 4 is like this. So there must be some presence of harmonics because of this one. So the helpful of the application of Gauges diagram is to identify whether the coil are wound in a correct pattern. So the next one is drop down the same thing, chart to display air gap MMF. You can get the peak to peak air gap MMF for your mission. So the air gap MMF in this case normalized is 3 with respect to the mechanical angle. So the animated is also possible to show with the air gap MMF. So finally, if you go and see the end winding, and you need to mention the gap between the frame to convert the heat to make some cooling arrangement and bearing the shaft, everything. So based on that, we can make the arrangements of the frame. So this is how it is going to be in the case of electric water pump. So this is core, the green color shows core, and this is overhanging, that is end winding, and inside this one this one is going to be bearing, and this is shaft, and this is going to be the end casing, and this is going to be either plane mount or otherwise it is going to be foot mount. So in this case it is going to be plane mount in this application, and this is going to connect with the engine. So then click the results, so it is available at the bottom of the page. So click the results. Once if you click the results, you can get this n number of performance criteria which is going to see in a step by step in the coming slides. So if you see the performance tables, the first one is nameplate. So as far as the induction machine is concerned, first we will check for our design whether the nameplate is going to be ideal for shoots for us or not. So if you see the nameplate, so it is phase is 3 and frequency is 163, that is at the speed of 4655. Voltage is 20 volt, that is the DC, ampere is 23 amps, power factor and efficiency, equivalent horsepower is 671. So the if you convert into power, it is going to be around 380 watts. And we arrow 380 watts. That is what shown in the nameplate. So the next one is the equivalent circuit. The basic equivalent circuit of the induction machine here, and you one can calculate what is the R1 stator resistance, rotor resistance, magnetizing inductance, everything. So with respect to R1, L1, L2, R2, R. So based on this also, it is possible to calculate the torque and output power of the machine. So the next one, in the performance chart, it is going to be the torque. Choose the torque and run the click view result. So it is going to show with different types of with respect to speed. So your speed is 5000. So your rated speed is 4900, and your current speed is this one. So you can get the starting torque of 0.52 or something above 0.52 Newton meter, and the breakdown torque is going to be 1.3 Newton meter. So the next one is efficiency. The same thing with respect to the speed. If you see the efficiency of the machine, it is comes around 87% at no load. So then the starting current is, if you see the current, so the starting current is going to be minimum 5 times greater than your rated current. So the power factor is going to be 0.79. So the final summary of the all the performance altogether, if you plot, this will be the final summary of the designed machine, which gives the torque, efficiency, voltage, current, power factor, as well as efficiency. So then Before going to deal with the thermal analysis, first we need to check with the PWM analysis whether the machine is going to perform in the satisfied manner. So go to the analysis chart, click PWM analysis. In that PWM analysis, check whether your required torque is going to produce or not. So this is the PWM analysis, and once if you get the average value, so you get a torque, what is the torque requirement, output power, efficiency, RMS current, power factor, supply current, RMS magnitude current, as well as rotor speed. So the first one is, you just choose PWM analysis. In that, display method is waveform, and result quantity is torque. If you want to torque with respect to phase, rotor angle, so rotor phase angle, then you take torque alone. In the operating point, you just choose simulation type as PWM bridge. Bus voltage input is value of voltage, that is 24 volt. Already we discussed this one. Slip is drive frequency, and the value of frequency is 163, which is corresponds to 4650 RPM. So once if you click torque and view results, so you are going to get this torque curve where the average is going to be required 0.57 torque. So the next one is current. It is going to be the around 20 amps of current is going to be, and the phase display is going to be A phase, and line current is going to be, this is 20 amps, around 20 amps. So the next one is total loss. The total loss of the machine, including copper core, this is going to be the total loss of the machine. And if you see the bar current, it is going to be around 40 degrees. It is going to be 40 amps. The current density is going to of the machine is 8.9 ampere per mm square. At the rotor speed of 163 RPM, and this is the torque with respect to the output power, and we need output power of 0.38, so output power, so the torque is going to be around 0.665 with respect to output power here. This is equivalent circuit analysis. The same thing, we can calculate, one can calculate equivalent circuit analysis also, what is the loss in the winding, iron loss, other losses like friction, windage, and stray load losses. If you see, the stray load loss is closely follows the torque path, and your windage losses is exponentially proportional to your rotor speed, and your friction loss is linear with respect to the rotor speed. Coming to the PWM analysis, the next method is harmonic content magnitude. You can find harmonic, how many availability of the harmonic content. In that harmonic content magnitude, the first one I wish to see is result quantity is current in A phase. So the harmonic content in A phase, it is going to be around 19 amps. So other fundamental frequency is 5.43 hertz, and other rated frequency is given here. So the next one is voltage. Voltage is going to be 24 volt. The harmonic fundamental frequency is given, and with respect to the fundamental frequency. So the next one is torque. It is going to be around 0.54. The next one is harmonic content phase angle. Then here it is harmonic content with phase angle, magnitude and phase angle, so that you can get both positive as well as negative. Similarly, we can get it same graph for phase angle. Current, this is for voltage, and this is for voltage, and this is for current. So coming to the next one, it is going to be the fields. So you can one can identify the instantaneous fields, field in density, total losses, everything in this plot. So first in the field analysis, it is instantaneous field. In instantaneous field, you can go and choose counter plot field. Choose flux in phase, shaded plot field, flux density, shaded plot field component, RMS magnitude, arrow plot field, it is none, arrow plot field component, in phase component. So the other operating point we need to specify is voltage method. It is specified voltage. Specified voltage is 24. Speed input method is value of speed, and synchronous speed is 4900. Slip input method is value in percentage, that is the slip is 5. So rotor position, you can change rotor position as you wish. As this is the induction machine, no need to give any specific rotor position. So once if you give these things, you just click view result, you can get the flux in phase, flux density, RMS magnitude. So the flux density is going to be 1.4 to the red. So here you can zoom it and you can see. So this red spots going to be 1442, and this yellow spots, this it is going to be 1.07, and the green parts here, it is going to be around 0.62 0.8, and the blue part is going to be here, in blue part it is going to be 0.0098 to 0.17. So the next one is flux in quadrature, that is Q axis, quadrature axis. So the remaining thing as it is, you can, and you can see the difference between the flux, even the, it is going to be same here, the saturation level and all, it is going to be different in case of this two. So if you see here, so there will be no flux. So if you see here in quadrature axis, the flux is going to pass in this case. So that is the difference in Q axis and D axis. So in, this is going to be the D axis, and this is going to be your Q axis. And even though if there is much as the magnetic flux, flux is going to be same, the flux density is also same with respect to the air. So the next one is flux density. You just go for the RMS flux density, and the RMS value in each and every part of the motor shows here the flux density value. And one of the biggest advantage in this software is we can find the relative permeability at each and every point of the core. So the relative permeability is going to be with respect to the flux density is showing here. The current density of the machine is around 10 ampere per mm square. So the current density is shown as the maximum current density value. So the next one is relative permeability in iron core. So if you see here, the iron core, this one, this that is a rotor back ion, stator teeth and all, is going to play around 7900 to 8500. So the relative permeability is very high, whereas in the air it is going to be 1. The relative permeability of the air here, it is going to be 1. So and somewhere in the teeth and all, it is going to be played between this LO, and it is going to be 6000, between 6300 to 6000. One is loss fields, and in the loss field you just choose ohmic loss in kilowatt. The software will provide the ohmic loss in kilowatt per mm cube, that is loss per volume. So the loss per volume of the machine is shown here. So the green and red, the value was plotted here. So it is in kilowatt per mm cube, that is loss per volume. So Next one is the stator coil ohmic loss, that is also in kilowatt per mm cube. So only the stator coil loss is shown. And the rotor ohmic loss, that is the bar loss. As the current is maximum in this bar, so the losses is also high in the rotor bar when compared with stator winding. So this will be the total loss. So if you see the total loss, the rotor bar losses is greater than your stator winding losses. So the next one is hysteresis loss, which is going to be the hysteresis loss in the core alone. So other part, the hysteresis loss is going to be zero. And eddy current loss, the same thing, wherever the flux reversal is there, the eddy current loss shows here. So here the flux, it's very minimal eddy current. So in stator only you have eddy current loss. So next, coming to the thermal chart. Based on the electromagnetic design, having the knowledge of losses in different parts of the machine, based on the losses one can estimate the thermal temperature rise in each and every part of the machine. So here I display the total losses, which is going to be loss in the winding, rotor cage loss, rotor iron loss, stator back end loss, stator teeth loss, rotor back end loss, rotor teeth, friction loss, windage loss, and stray load losses. So based on these losses, these are the these are going to be the inputs for the thermal analysis of the machine. So as this is the automotive application, the electric water pump is going to be inside the vehicle. So we choose the ambient temperature as 35 degrees Celsius. So after running for steady state operating temperature, you just click view result, then you can find what will be the temperature rise, average temperature rise in bar, rotor back iron, rotor tooth, stator back iron, stator coil size, stator coil side, slot mate, and stator tooth. So if you see the bar, the temperature is 105 degrees Celsius. Rotor back iron 104 degrees Celsius, rotor teeth 105 degrees Celsius, stator back iron 79.4 degrees Celsius, stator coil side 84.5 degrees Celsius, stator coil side slot mate it is 84.6 degrees Celsius, stator tooth 84.1 degrees Celsius. So next, click the temperature and come here, keep the design prototype design 1, result quantity as temperature maximum. And always show y-axis. These two things you keep as the components. What are all the components you want to plot as a graph? So in this one, I want to plot what is the temperature rise for a stator coil side, stator left end winding, and right end winding. So this end winding is going to be the major. Is going to be the temperature is going to be greater than the coil side. So I just run for 180 minutes. That is 3 hours. So I run for 3 hours, and this is going to be the 35 degrees Celsius, that is the room temperature. And from that room temperature, if you see here, so after around 30 minutes, the stator end winding, stator coil side, the temperature get saturated, and the maximum temperature you can get it for stator coil side, stator left end winding, and right end winding. So it is going to be around 85 degrees Celsius. So as you see here, it is going to be 84.5, 84.6, 84.1. So coming to the next one, it is going to be stator back iron, stator slot liner, stator tooth. So the temperature, same thing, the machine is run for 180 minutes and I plot the graph. So the room temperature is 35 degrees Celsius. So you can get the temperature curve. So similarly, it shows here. So the next one is rotor back arm, rotor bar, rotor left end ring, rotor right end ring, rotor tooth shaft. So these are the so more or less these things are going to be 105 degrees Celsius, and the shaft alone it is going to be some 95 degrees Celsius. So you can see the average value here. So approximately it is 105 degrees Celsius in this case. So the shaft is going to be 95 degrees Celsius. So again, it is going to be rotor back iron, rotor bar, rotor left ring, stator back iron, stator coil side, stator right end winding, stator tool. So I just compare everything in here. Single graph so that it is easy to understand how far the temperature difference is going to be there between rotor as well as in the stator. Yes. So here I can one can see the entire part of the machine, that is casing, housing, left end plate, left inner bearing, left outer bearing, right end plate, right flange, right inner bearing, right outer bearing. So those things it is going on. So it is possible to check those temperatures, the temperature hotspots in that particular case, in that particular region. So this one is quite helpful to see the entire temperature zones, hotspots in each and every. No can comment on the machine now. See here, one can open the, I just show the motor saw, which the motor saw model which we use for this video lecturing. So you can see how it is possible to how it can be done through this one. Click the nameplate and you click view result, you can get the nameplate details. So for phase 3, frequency, voltage, RPM, current, horsepower, power factor, efficiency. Similarly, you click the equivalent circuit view result, so you can get the equivalent circuit value and torque and the performance charts. It takes some so you can get the torque value. So 0.7 is the starting torque and that is going to be up to 5000 RPM and this is going to be your load curve. So similarly you can view the efficiency also. So the efficiency is going to be around 85% and voltage, current, power factor. So power factor it is here it is 0.79 and this is the total summary. One can check the current, voltage, everything with respect to the rotor speed. So this basic knowledge is more than enough to design induction machine for a particular application. So if you come for a thermal chart, so then you can go and check whatever the thing you can want to. You just choose whatever the thing you want to plot. So then if you click view result, automatically you will get what are all the so it is going to solve for 14 steps, so it takes some more time to find. Stop time here it is 60, so I can go for 180 minutes so that it is easy to check whether the temperature gets saturated in that particular point or otherwise it keep on increasing or not. So those things it is possible to easily verify based on this thermal charts. So this is going to be play a vital role in designing the machine. So let us see whether this shows. See this one. So if you see this one, it is going to be the better the criteria for this one. So it makes sense. So what happens if this is the going to be the yes? So it's all. So you can be, the housing. If you see the hub under, it is go for 180 degrees Celsius, 140 degrees Celsius. So similarly, one can understand the. And the thermal parameters, number parameters also is possible. Also possible to do in this case. If you want to have arrange a cooling system, you can arrange a cooling system. So the most important thing is this one, PWM analysis. That whatever the thing you want, you can choose and you can plot it. So the thing is just I choose the waveform for time. Output power, then what else? different rotor speeds, the output power, the input power, and torque. So one can modify whatever the thing we required for the drive system. So those things comes into picture. And so coming to this one, winding. So if you come for temperature, so all the temperature is within the limit of 140 degrees Celsius. So the maximum temperature is the input. What we the specification demands is this is the specification demands. If you see the specification demands, it is going to be 125 degrees Celsius. So the temperature on all the parts of the machine is going to be less than 125 degrees Celsius. So whatever the machine designed with this stator OD and axial length for this our rating, it is going to be better. You can get it in rotor bar, which is around 105 degrees Celsius. So here, note that the machine runs at 3 hours. So even if we extend the time of this one for 5 hours, there will be the same, the temperature rise is going to be the same in the machine. So the next one is temperature maximum housing. If you see the housing, left end plate, left inner bearing, left outer bearing, right end plate, right flange, right inner bearing, right outer bearing. So all the cases are going to be the same in all the cases. We can find run the machine for 3 hours. So the temperature rise is going to be here. So if you see the housing, so this is the temperature housing. It is 61 degrees Celsius. Left inner bearing, it is around 76-77 degrees Celsius. And if you see the right end plate, it is less than 40 degrees Celsius. And flange and all, it is going to be around less than 40 degrees Celsius. So which is going to be seen here. So then you go to thermal fields, check out the shaded plot field, click choose the temperature and stop time, you just give a 180 degree, and duty interval it is going to be 1 for duration 1, and the second duty interval is going to be 180 minutes. So you can give a duty cycle as your wish. If it is the short time duty cycle, you can include a short time duty cycle also. So that it is, you can get a stepped waveform, or otherwise you can get a for that particular interval, what is the rise time and the fall time of the machine. So the components I choose for this is rotor back ion. So this is rotor back ion, rotor bar, stator teeth, stator coil, and stator back ion. So if you see this, see the stator bar and rotor. It is going to play with 104-105 degree. This is 105 degree, this is 104 degree. So whereas if you see the stator core, so it is around the stator here, it is 78 degrees Celsius, and here it is around 84 degrees Celsius, and here it is 85.6 degrees Celsius, and here this one it is 83.9 to 84.8 degrees Celsius. So this is a slot liner. The insulation is going to place here, and one can easily understand this temperature rise by plotting the shaded plot of the temperature. And if you want to have a resolution and accuracy more, then you can take the sales accuracy maximum time step. You can increase the time step and iterations also. And here I put a speed accuracy as a process. You can go for slowest also, so that it is going to be useful for the entire analysis. So as far as the design is concerned, temperature wise as well as if you see the performance in the indices, that is yeah, if you see the performance of PPW performance, if you see the performance of PWM analysis, it is going to be the required torque, it is going to be 780. Output power, it comes around 380 watts. The required is 380 watts. We get 381 watts. Efficiency, it is more than 82%. Current, it is 20.9 amps. Power factor, 0.656. Supply current is 90.9 amps. Magnetizing current is 9.12 amps. Rotor speed is 4646 RPM. So this is what that was shown in the design index of so power factor, voltage, torque, current with respect to the efficiency, with the efficiency, all with respect to the rotor speed. So finally, if you see this nameplate and nameplate detail, and just if you compare with the specifications, so almost all the specifications are satisfied by our design. So, and if you go for the cost wise analysis, it is approximately 27% lesser cost than existing brushless DC machine. So the maintenance and also it is not required that much when compared with the DC commutator motor. So the induction motor is going to be the ideal choice for electric water pump in automotive application. So I wish to thank my research associate Mr. Satyanarayana, who is working with me for the past 3 years. So he is doing research in induction motor drives. And he is designing different types of induction motors for automotive applications, including electric two-wheelers, electric three-wheelers, electric buses. So thanks to my research associate who is involving in this design. Thank you. We will meet once again in the same electric water pump application. Instead of induction machine, if you go for some other machine, what are all the pros and cons that is going